Hi everybody, I'm making a chicken curry today, but this is a different kind of chicken curry because this is bhuni hui murgi. So basically what I'm going to do is bhuno a whole lot and the curry will be drier than a normal murgi. I've taken a kg, out of which half a kg is chicken on bones and half a kg of breast boneless pieces, and I've cut them into that size. And first off, what I'm going to do is take a pan like this and dry roast these masalas. There's 1 teaspoon each of coriander seeds, cumin. There's about half a teaspoon of black pepper. There are 2 or 3 cardamoms, 2 or 3 sticks of cinnamon, and a few pieces of cloves, about 4 or 5. Dry roast this, and then I'm going to put it in the grinder and make powder out of this. I've grinded that, and that is smelling so good. I just want to tell you that I had rubbed some turmeric powder, red chili powder, and salt on this. So basically half a teaspoon each of turmeric and red chili powder and a teaspoon of salt. Rub this and set it aside. Here I have a wok that I put up on the stove, and I've added about 1/4 cup of oil. I'm going to be frying this chicken in that, and then I'm going to remove this chicken and then proceed with the rest of the recipe. One has to bhuno this very, very well. At least 3 to 4 minutes till the chicken turns white. I browned the chicken very nicely. It took about 5 to 6 minutes. I'm going to set this aside. And in the same oil, I shall be now frying the onions till it's brown. Fry this till it's brown, and then we're going to add 1 tablespoon each of ginger and garlic chopped. You may make a paste of it, but then you have to add slightly more than 1 tablespoon. And that takes a good 10 to 12 minutes to brown. I'm going to be adding 1 tablespoon each of ginger and garlic chopped. Saute this well. And at this point, I'm going to be adding 1 can of tomatoes. You may use 1/2 kg of regular tomatoes. And I'm going to be a little indulgent here, and I'm going to be adding at least 2 to 3 tablespoons of desi ghee. And wait for the tomato to cook well, in the sense that it will now leave the oil. This also takes a good 10 to 12 minutes. This murgi chicken dish is all about bhunoing, about sauteing till the water dries, and bhunoing it really well. Okay, so in the meantime, I just want to show you the masala that I've grounded is right here. And I've added about 1 teaspoon each of cumin powder, coriander powder, fenugreek. There is chaat masala, 1 teaspoon of dried chili flakes, 2 bay leaves, and here I have about 1 cup of beaten Greek yogurt. So you can just use any yogurt that isn't sweet. And here is about 2-3 tablespoons of coriander, 2-3 tablespoons of fresh mint, and I have blended that with 4 green chilies which were deseeded. So these are the next ingredients that are going to go up in this bhunawa chicken. And that right there is salt, which is most important. Alright, so after that I'm going to be adding the chicken pieces into the bhunawa tomato and giving it a good mix. A good mix means at least 2 to 3 minutes. And then after that I should be adding the masalas. This is smelling good and it's a lovely color. Let's mix the masalas. Bhuno this very, very well, and might add a splash of water to get rid of the masala smell. Raise the fire, add a little water and bruno this so it will aid in getting rid of the masala smell like I mentioned earlier. This is now smelling really, really good, guys. Okay, I've lowered the fire and now it's time to add 1 cup of Greek yogurt and the green chutney that I left a little watery so that this would add to the curry of this lovely dish. Okay, I've lowered the fire and I'm going to cover this and cook this for 10 minutes. It's smelling really, really good. I don't want you to add any water to this. Let's wait 10 minutes and come back to it. And right at the end, just 1 teaspoon of vinegar. mix it well. And garnish with coriander. And mint. Thank you for watching, guys. I hope you like this recipe and I hope you make it too.